one of the reasons why the Congress hasn't done well, Aditi, is because we are so happily reconciled to losing to the BJP. I think the Congress party needs a president who is upset, agitated, and pacing up and down and, you know, blowing the ceiling apart every time we lose even a municipal election.
Hi, you're watching Hindustan Times and I'm Aditi Prasad. I have with me Sanjay Jha, who has been suspended from the Congress party and continues to be a vocal critic of the party's way of handling crises in recent years. But his book, The Great Unraveling, India After 2014, is set to be launched in the next week. And while, you know, he self-admittedly says that he's equally critical of the BJP and the Congress in this book, but as I was going through a few excerpts from the book, I noticed, Sanjay, that you had devoted four full chapters to the ruling party, its economic blunders, the crumbling of institutions, etc., and finally just one to the Congress party, where you, as an insider, would have infinitely more to say. Any particular reason for that, Sanjay?
Well, Aditi, frankly, India is such a fascinating country, complex, diverse, multiple challenges, and, you know, experiencing all kinds of radical developments on a daily basis. Just think about it. After the Bihar election results were out, nobody would have thought that suddenly the BJP will face a political crisis with the farmer protests, which have completely paralyzed the government. So, you know, politics in our country is extremely kaleidoscopic. You know, things happen at a very rapid pace. But to answer your question, you know, when I talk about the great unraveling India after 2014, clearly the big responsibility for the questions being raised on Indian democracy or its syncretism or its, what I call is the larger issues of society, of governance, of freedom. These are matters that are of paramount importance to every citizen of India. And the responsibility largely has to be with the government. The opposition has been far too frail and small to be able to take on this government. Now, as an insider, I can only comment on what I know of the Congress and what are the kind of errors or judgmental mistakes that we made. I'm not a fly on the wall in the BJP's office. And therefore, you know, if you look at the entire book in its entirety, you'll find that the chapter on the Congress is evoking a lot of interest simply because I've chosen to call a spade a spade.
From 44 seats in 2014 to 52 seats in 2019, how do you think the Congress party can be revived? Do you have any prescriptions that you've set out for the grand old party in your book?
Well, frankly, Aditi, you know, the joke goes that a lot of people in the Congress party were very happy that we almost grew by 20%, you know, from 44 to 52. But on a serious note, the fact is that the Congress party deserves better. This is a party that once upon a time used to win 350 seats almost as a matter of convention or tradition. We used to always get around 35 to 40% of the vote share, maybe more than 40 on many an occasion. So why has the Congress party suddenly become so, shall we say, weak, lacking the kind of impact it used to make? Why has it drifted so away from the mainstream Indian politics? Why are the public so disillusioned by the Congress? I think the tragedy for the Congress, and which I point out in my chapter, is our inability to actually address the issue head on, take the bull by the horns, accept where you made a mess, accept the reality that you screwed up on many a times, and then begin to get your house in order. And I do believe that the buck stops at the top. And if anybody needs to take the responsibility for it, it'll have to be the people who have been the Congress presidents.
In one of your recent pieces that I was reading, you asked Rahul Gandhi to behave like Sachin Tendulkar and step down as the captain of the Congress. Why this analogy? And do you think that's going to make a difference?
Well, first and foremost, I'm personally very fond of Rahul. I think he's a very good human being. He's got good intentions and he means well. The problem is that when he resigned in May 2019 after the Lok Sabha defeat, Aditi, he, in my opinion, did something fairly extraordinary, not seen in politics, not just in India, but worldwide, taking complete moral responsibility and saying now the Congress needs a non-dynastic leader and the Congress Working Committee should choose one. The problem is that we are now entering 2021 in a couple of weeks, and it'll be nearly 2 years, and the Congress party hasn't bothered to have a new leader. Rahul has to take responsibility for it, because if Rahul wanted, he had to just send out a message to the CWC telling him that I want this selection to be done within a couple of weeks. And I don't think anybody in the CWC would have objected or, you know, obstructed that decision coming from Mr. Gandhi, because in the Congress party, the Gandhis have a very sacrosanct elevated status. Now, why did Rahul not do it? I think he's the only person who can answer that. But today, I'll tell you why I believe Rahul needs to be inspired by what Sachin Tendulkar did. Because Rahul actually said, I'm not coming back. If Rahul were to come back as the Congress president in 2021 in the next couple of weeks when there are elections in the AICC, I won't be surprised if the BJP, the media, the public of India says, how do I trust Rahul Gandhi, who says I'm not coming back and he comes back? Obviously, they'll say in politics anything can happen, but I don't think it will add to either Rahul's credibility or the Congress's reputation, because people will now say, are you saying that other than the Gandhis, the Congress doesn't have a leader to take the country forward? In which case, we got a serious talent deficit. That's bad news for the Congress. And Rahul needs to walk the talk. You know, I mean, he's still young. He can still come back as a Congress president another tenure. He can even at some point take up another big role in the party, in the government. It all depends. It's all up in the air. And Tendulkar, Aditi, did exactly that. He was a captain. He wasn't doing too well. It was affecting his batting. The team was uninspired under his leadership. And it's unfortunate. It's not that Tendulkar did not try. But Tendulkar, I mean, the world's best batsman, for heaven's sake. But he decided to take the call that I'm going to quit the captaincy. Not that the selectors were asking him to go. Not that BCCI told him we're going to sack you. He chose to go because he realized it was affecting his own performance and the team was losing. What happened after Tendulkar quit? Saurav Ganguly became the captain. Indian cricket went through a major transmogrification. It was a renaissance of sorts. And we did remarkably well. We entered the finals of the World Cup. We won the Champions Trophy. And later on, MS Dhoni went on to win the World Cup. And guess what? MS Dhoni was Tendulkar's captain. And that was the biggest dream that Tendulkar had. So I'd rather have Rahul Gandhi as a part of a winning team in 2024 and other elections, as opposed to him leading the party and then being rejected by the people because, you know, the mood has become very anti-dynastic. And that is something that Rahul Gandhi will have to accept.
Who do you think is the Saurav Ganguly of the Congress party right now then in that case?
Well, you could have even said Sachin because we got one in our party. But I do feel, Aditi, that there is no shortage of talent. There are a number of people in G23 I have a lot of great respect for. But I would say that... a Sachin Pilot, a Sashi Tharoor, maybe even a Mukul Wasnik. You have veterans in the party as well. You know, it depends upon how energetic they can be on the ground level. It's a tough job. You know, it's easy to, kind of pontificate and say we need a new leader. But you need somebody ambitious, hungry, great communicator, a team player, a risk taker, and someone who is combative, you know, who hates to lose. I believe one of the reasons why the Congress hasn't done well, Aditi, is because we are so happily reconciled to losing to the BJP. I think the Congress party needs a president who is upset, agitated, and pacing up and down and, you know, blowing the ceiling apart every time we lose even a municipal election. If you don't have that jazba, that junoon in you, that passion in you to fight to win, I don't think the Congress party is going to beat this big, massive machine politics of the BJP. But I do believe there are good candidates. And, you know, one option that we have is, you know, have four vice presidents, north, east, south, and west, and a president. So you create a team of five people. And you know, each one gets a chance to be president after 2 years. You know, you can create models because there's no shortage of talent in the party.